Okay, so this is our third lecture, directional derivatives and gradients. So before going to directional derivatives, let us record derivative of function in one variable. So you already know that what is a function in one variable. Function in one variable, we usually notate y equal to f of x is a function where y is a dependent variable and x is independent variable. So this is a function from R, real line to real line. Okay. So that means our domain is a real line and image is a real line. So any point A here, we can have some point f of A in the domain. Okay, so if we draw the graph of this function, we will get a graph in a plane. So this is something like y equal to f of x. So if A is a point here, their corresponding image is here. So for a one variable function, we can draw graph in a plane. And we already studied what is derivative f dash of a, derivative of a. This is simply limit x tends to a f of x minus f of a divided by x minus a. That means rate of change of f with respect to x at the point a. So here if a is a point here, so this limit exists only when left and right hand limit exist. This limit exists only when left and right hand limit exist. That means the x approaches a either through left side or through right side. So there is only two path to x to approach a, because our domain is a line, okay, real line. Now, or in another definition, we can use the limit h tends to 0 f of a plus h minus f of a divided by h. This is also another definition of derivative in one variable. So also we dy by dx, this is derivative of y with respect to x. So this is what we studied in your plus 2 and now in the first semester we have studied partial derivatives of functions of several variables, for example functions of two variables. So what is a function of two variables? We usually notate z equal to f of xy. Here x and y are independent variable and z is dependent variable. Okay, so here the thing is our domain is a plane R2, that is any point x y or x naught y naught we will map into some real number or some real number. For example, f of x y equal to x square plus y square. This is any point x, y map into a real number. So that is f of 3, 2 is equal to 3 square plus 2 square. That is equal to 25. 30. So real number, some number here. So we can notate this, the graph of the function in z equal to f of xy, something like a surface. So this is xy plane. So any point x naught, y naught, yes, you can map the point here. So now we will define what is partial derivative. So we already know that partial derivative of f with respect to x is rate of change of f with respect to x. So that is simply we will consider y as a constant, right? Look, this is fx naught y naught. So x naught y naught is a point here, And what we will do is we will consider y as a constant. So what we will do is we will cut this by a plane, y equal to y naught. And then on this plane, we have a curve. The function is simply a curve C1. And we will take rate of change of this function that is parallel to x-axis. Okay. So that we what we will get a dou f by dou x. And for a slope fy x naught y naught is, we will take rate of change with respect to y. That means we will cut x equal to x naught, a plane x equal to x naught, and our curve is this, and we will take rate of change with respect to y. So that is a slope. That is what about functions partial derivative of a function. That means here fx is rate of change, instantaneous rate of change with respect to x, that is moving towards parallel to x-axis, and instantaneous fy is instantaneous rate of change that moving parallel to y-axis. Okay, so now the problem is you can okay, if x naught y naught is a point here, okay, x naught y naught is a point here, we can approach x naught y naught in through any direction. Okay, so and also we can find rate of change of f of xy at x naught y naught at any direction, any direction. So if you take a vector u, we can find rate of change of f of xy in the direction u. Okay, so if we find rate of change, instantaneous rate of change of y f of xy, z equal to f of xy in the direction of u, you will get a new derivative. Such a derivative is called partial derivative. So I will define what is partial derivative. If f of xy is a function of x and y, and if u equal to u1i plus u2j is a unit vector, then the directional derivative of f in the direction of u at x naught y naught is denoted by du f of x naught y naught is the partial derivative with respect to s d by ds f of x naught plus s u1 y naught plus s u2. That means u1i plus u2j is the vector that in the direction of that vector. And one of the important thing is this must be a unit vector. What is unit vector? When we say that u equal to u1i plus u2j is unit vector, anybody? When we say that it's a unit vector, if norm of u is equal to 1, u is a unit vector if norm of u equal to 1, that is root of u1 square plus u2 square is equal to 1, then we say that u is a unit vector. Okay, if u is not a unit vector, so the given vector is not a unit vector, how to make it a unit vector? Anybody? How to convert a vector into unit vector? For example, if you have a vector a equal to a1i plus a2j, which is not a unit vector, then how to change it into unit vector? Anybody? How to convert a vector divided by norm of a vector, right? So then this new u vector must be a unit vector. Okay. So this is the actual definition of directional derivative. But for calculating directional derivative by using this definition is difficult. So we will use partial derivatives to find directional. So this is what is about a directional derivative. So u in the direction of u, moving towards the direction of u, what will be the instantaneous rate of change of f of x. So this is the geometric representation. Okay, now we want to find out a partial derivative or directional derivative by using partial derivative. So for a function that is differentiable at a point, directional derivative exists in every direction from the point can be computed directly in terms of first order partial derivatives. So now we can find directional derivative by using first order partial derivative. So I will give you the theorem. So by using this theorem we can find directional derivative by using first order partial derivative. So if f of xy is differentiable at x naught y naught, and if u is equal to u1i plus u2j is a unit vector. If the given vector is not unit vector, then we will convert it into unit vector. Then the directional derivative dou u du f of x naught y naught exists, and it's given by du f of x naught y naught is equal to fx. This is partial derivative with respect to x. X naught y naught into u1 plus fy x naught y naught into u2. So u1 and u2 is this. So this is partial derivative. If it is in three variable and the unit vector is u1i plus u2j plus u3k, then du f of x naught y naught z naught is equal to fx x naught y naught z naught u1 fy u2 fz u3. Okay, so this is the formula. Now it is very easy to find directional derivative of a function. So any question? Otherwise we can move to problems. So now we can do an example. So the question is, find the directional derivatives of a function f of xy equal to e raised to xy at minus 2, 0 in the direction of a unit vector that makes an angle of pi by 3 with a positive x-axis. Okay. So we want to find out the directional derivative of this function in at x naught y naught is minus 2, 0 in the direction of a unit vector. We have not given the unit vector, but unit vector that makes an angle pi by 3 is the positive solution. So we know that the definition of directional derivative du f of x naught y naught is equal to fx x naught y naught u1 fy x naught y naught u2. So now we want to find out what is u1 and u2. X naught y naught is equal to minus 2, 0, right? Now, we want to find out the unit vector that makes an angle. Unit vector, so length of the vector is 1. Makes an angle pi by 4. So, in the positive x-axis, this is positive x-axis. Now, this is our u1, u2, and the length of this is 1, and the angle is pi by 3. So tell me what is u1, u2, u equal to u1i plus u2j. So this angle is pi by 3, and length of this vector is 1, then what will be u1 and u2? Anybody? In polar form you can write, right? What is u1? This length r cos theta, right? U2 is r sin theta. So here r is length of this vector 1. Theta is pi by 3. So this is cos pi by 3 I plus sin pi by 3 j. So that is u1 and u2. So why? Because given that it's a unit vector, so the length r is 1 and it makes an angle pi by 3, so we can easily find u1 and u2. So now we will find the partial derivatives of f are fxxy is equal to y e raised to xy, fyxy equal to x e raised to xy. Now we will substitute this value. Fx minus 2, 0 is 0, fy minus 2, 0. You just apply this value, then minus 2. So we already find u. U is cos pi by 3i plus sin I pi by 3j. So that is 1 by 2. Cos pi by 3 is 1 by 2. Sin pi by 3 is root 3 by 2. So the directional derivative is du f of minus 2, 0. Fx minus 2, 0 cos pi by 3 plus fy minus 2, 0 sin pi by 3. So we know that fx minus 2, 0, this is 0, that we already find, that is 0, and fy minus 2 is minus. So this is minus 2, so we will get 0 into 1 by 2. Minus 2 into root 3 by 2, this is minus root 3. So, the directional derivative of a function is, vector valued function is always a scalar quantity. Now, you do this problem. Find the directional derivative of f of x, y, z, x square y minus y z cube plus z at the point 1 minus 2, 0 in the direction of a vector a equal to this. Tell me, is a is unit vector or not? Is a is unit vector? Is a is unit vector? Tell me.
No, sir.
No. So what we have to do, we have to convert it into, we have to normalize and make it a unit vector. Okay. So you do this problem. So this is the definition for finding a directional derivative. Okay. Then you find that this is our function. Now you have you got partial derivative of f r? Fx is 2xy, fy is x square minus z cube, fz is minus y z square. Have you got the answer? Then you find out fx 1 minus 2, 0 minus 4, fy 1 minus 2, 0 1, fz 1 minus 2, 0 equal to 2 is equal to 1. Okay, have we completed? Then we here is not a unit vector, so we have to normalize it. So how do you normalize? We will find a by norm a. So norm a is root 9, and we will divide. Now our u is a unit vector. And the answer is minus 3. Okay. Have you got answer is minus 3? So that's also a scalar quantity. Now you note it down these problems. Okay.